You know, this all comes down to humiliation and worth and deserving and security issues and safety issues. And all of that means nothing because of what's inside of you. So take what you have inside of you, take what you're already endorsing, and turn it into an exchange of energy. Okay, just jumping on right at 10 a.m. Thank you everybody for joining me. For this particular webinar, you guys will not be able to interact with me just because I wanna keep my stream of consciousness, and there's a lot of information that I wanna pack in about an hour's time. So hold your questions. Actually, you could throw them in the comment section of this live video. And what we're going to do is whatever kind of birthed itself from this particular webinar, I'll do a live question and answer in probably about a month from now. Because I know that this is going to bring up a lot of questions, but I'm hoping to also answer a lot of questions that you guys have had about wealth, money, abundance, and whatever is in your block about that. So first of all, for those of you who are just seeing my grill for the very first time, I am Jessica Alstrom, and I am an intuitive life coach, and I work all over the world helping people with the how of their life. The confirmations, the connecting the dots, the putting the journey together, and really creating an amazing life of purpose, joy, freedom, abundance, love, you know, the whole reason why we're here. That is my favorite thing in the whole world, is to help someone kind of connect the dots and really move through what has been blocking and sticking them for a long time. I know that if you're watching me, you've probably been on this journey for a while. And like most light workers, you know, you guys think about money, it's like, you know, because really all you ever want to do on this planet is be of service. And I know that. So what I want to do first is jump in and really ask you guys to let go of your belief systems for today. Really let go of the way that you have kind of put and organized your thoughts about abundance, money, freedom, joy, being an adult, being a light worker, being different, being a black sheep. Let's just put everything, let's put all of our labels away just for the next hour. And just go into, you know, the opposite of belief systems, which is ideas. Because I want to take you guys on a journey with this whole new understanding of who you really are as a light worker, the true purpose of why you're here, and what that means for you personally and the planet. So first of all, let's define what a light worker is. So if you are like, am I a light worker? I mean, I don't know if I'm a light worker. I can't like move energy or read tarot cards yet, but you know, I'm into all this stuff. I'm fascinated by all that stuff. You're in the right place. And that means you're a light worker. Because to me, the definition of a light worker is someone who brings light to the dark. That's it. Light to the dark. And what does that mean? Brings love to fear, brings, you know, change to places that need change, needs understanding, needs a hug, needs compassion, understanding. This is what a lightworker's true definition is someone who brings light to the dark. And I know that you've been doing this your whole life. I know that you did this for your family. I know that you've done this for your friends. I know that you really want to do this for yourself. And if you are one who brings light to the dark, what is light? Light is technically defined as information. It is understanding. It is compassion. It is service. It is acceptance. It is all of these things that we truly, truly are at our really intimate core. And we can't change it no matter how many times our heart gets broken, no matter how many times we fail, no matter how many times people fail us. The resonant point of who we are never changes. It doesn't mean that we don't build that hard candy shell in our way of receiving love, because most light workers suck at receiving, but we don't ever, ever, ever change who we are. And that is your greatest value. Okay. So I wanted to kind of, because we're letting go of belief systems this morning and we're moving into ideas, I wanted to give you guys some really funny definitions, because, and they're funny to me, because I love taking a word and really dissecting it and really kind of understanding it at its core, because we hear the word money and we're like, we instantly have a program definition attached to it. Now, your program definition attached to the word money may not even be in your conscious reality. It can be a subconscious trigger. It can be an unconscious belief system, because that word money got thrown around a lot as a child. And even though you have a logical adult definition of what money is, your subconscious may have a completely different definition of what money means to you. So we need to kind of uncover some of our belief systems while we're giving them the way this morning. So I wanted to give you guys a definition of wealth, because I noticed how I didn't say get rich being a light worker. I used the word wealth. And the reason why I used the word wealth in this webinar was because, because it actually is a noun, and it means an abundance of valuable possessions or money. Abundance of valuable possessions. Get a mirror out. You're looking at that. You are looking at wealth in the mirror. You are an abundance of value. You have been bringing value to this planet since the day you were born, whether it was making someone laugh, helping them solve a problem, you know, taking them on a ride, giving them a hug, sitting with them in the dark. Your value is your worth, okay? And we have this trigger that happens when we're on this journey where we see other people that are wealthy and rich, and they behave in a way that maybe isn't in alignment with what our true heart's desire is. And so we build a definition of what that looks like, what wealth looks like, what rich means. And as I was kind of going through the definitions this morning to find some fun ones, I pulled up the word rich, and it means having a great deal of money or assets. Assets. How many certifications do you have? How many products do you recommend to your friends and family? How many job hats do you technically wear for the people in your life? Most lightworkers that I know are a sous chef, where your basic nutritionist that knows 1,000 times more than the doctor with the PhD. We understand energy and currency of exchange. We understand what the meaning of your words are, what you're saying underneath it as an empath. And I'm sorry, that is a shiz ton of assets. And you're looking at your own wealth and you're looking at your own assets. But here's what happens with lightworkers. Because these things are so inherent to us, because these things are not something that we went out and earned, it isn't something we paid for, it isn't something that we bought or that, you know, we begged someone to give it to us. It is something that is so close to us that sometimes we forget what it is, what we are, what we have. And what we are inside of us is the true value. But because it comes so effortless to you, because helping someone through a dark time feels like nothing to you, you don't see the value of that. And therefore, when you see someone who's gone and worked really, really hard in college, and they've got a big, fat, long lettered degree after their name, your subconscious puts them in a position where they are more valuable than you, or they have something more valuable than you, because they had to go through a process to get it. Now, most of the lightworkers that I know on this planet are rebellions. We're rule breakers. So we get ourselves in those situations where we have to go to school for a really long time, or go get on the job training. And there's this natural rebuttal that happens in our energy field where we're like, almost for some reason, here to break down systems. We're here to not follow rules. You know, the lightworker community on this planet is very, very, very much like the artist community. And the artist community is the lightworking community, because we're bringing light to the dark. It's music, it's light, it's information, it's technologies, it's medicine. It's all of the things that is inside of us that we have, that we were basically taught at a very young age was not valuable. Okay, so if you guys have been following me for a while, or if you're just hearing me for the very first time, I teach my clients and my students how to play this abundance game. Now, I'm not going to go into that today because that's not what this webinar is about, but I want to give you guys the four frequencies of abundance so that as I'm talking about them today in this webinar, you can kind of grab and say, oh, okay, I get what she means by that. And basically, when I say there's four frequencies, a frequency is almost like it's a frequency is kind of like a belief system, and a belief system is what creates reality. So if I find the frequency of abundance inside of me and I project that and I act it out, then my body and my essence will become a magnet for that, because I'm focal consciousness, which means I am focused consciousness. And whatever I put my attention on, I bring to me, because my body is designed to be a living magnet. Electromagnetic energy, like attracts like. So there's four particular frequencies that if you get into alignment with each one of these frequencies, you will become a natural magnet for certain things. And the first frequency of absolute abundance, remember, value, lots of freedom, is worthiness. Okay. Do you feel worthy? Do you feel worthiness inside of you? Probably not if you've got money issues. All right. If you've got that blocked wall, there's probably still something in the way of you totally receiving your own mirrored reflection of the light that you bring this planet. Now, to me, if you guys are about to attend my I Am workshop coming up at the end of July, that's where you can handle all of your deep issues with unworthiness. But for now, what I want you to understand is that all of your unworthiness came from humiliation. It came from humiliation when you were being authentic, you know, when you were sweeping incorrectly and your dad shouted at you, or when you were trying to get mom's attention and she was giving your sister attention, when you were made fun of for what you had or didn't have, you were always pointed out to be different. Humiliation is one of the root causes of unworthiness. And again, it is something that we feel on this planet a lot still as adults, no matter how many times we've tried to hide or bury or dim our light down so we wouldn't be humiliated. We always end up getting that humiliation to return. So usually one of the reasons why people don't stand in the spotlight and take their power and share their truth and all of these things that we really need to be doing as light workers is because we have been so humiliated that now we dim our light so that we don't have to shine and we don't have to be in the spotlight. But our job is to bring light to the dark. So I want you to just think about that as an idea and look at worthiness. And the second frequency that is a make or break point for the abundant flow of money and circumstances and events and support systems and people and places that you need to create your major reality. The second one that gets in your way is, I do not deserve. Okay. This is completely linked with your inability to receive. Now, again, I know these frequencies that I'm sharing with you guys, I had all of them. I have all of them out of alignment, every single one of them. And this next one was rough for me because I made a lot of bad choices in my life when I was not awake, when I wasn't woke, right? I hurt people. I failed my family. I let people down. People let me down. And in return, that humiliation and that guilt and that shame that built up over my life, no matter how much I tried to be a good mom or be a good sister or could be a good daughter, it just wasn't working. So by the time I was a solid 35-year-old, I was the opposite of deserving. And to me, deserving comes from the inability to be able to really trust ourselves. Because when I don't feel like I deserve, I'm going to resist you helping me. It, because if you help me, that will trigger my humiliation and I will feel weak and small. So I'd rather if you didn't help me, but at the same spectrum, there's another side of me that is screaming for help, 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 help. There's one side that's saying, keep help away because it's humiliating and I don't want anyone to see me suffer. So I need to look tough and strong and I need to rescue everyone around me and I need to be there for everyone around me, but I also need help. So there's the frequency out of alignment that's going on. Now imagine if both of those stories are talking to law of attraction, right? And then we look at unworthiness, and we've got that story talking to law of attraction. Now, like the universe all only knows yes. So it's either saying yes to your unworthiness or it's saying yes to your worthiness. It's not deciding whether you are deserving or, you know, smart enough or educated enough, or you come from the right family, or you come from the right planet. It does not matter to the universe. It only knows yes. So the no is actually coming from us, you guys. The resistance of our own freedom, the resistance of our own abundance, it comes from these stories and programs that are built up in our consciousness, that are playing in the back of our computer or hard drive, that are completely talking to law of attraction. So, two points. We're first going to go into what is in the way. And then I'm going to give you the hows, the solutions, the whys. So don't worry, just be patient. Grab some popcorn, whatever. All right, so we've got unworthiness and we've got I don't deserve. Now think about that. Do you have either one of those playing at some low grade backstory behind all of the effort that you're putting out in your physical reality? Because I know most of the effort that you're putting out in your physical reality is attempting to rewire that program. But you can't rewire an energetic belief system program through physical action. The universe doesn't work that way. You actually have to change the program at the root energetic point, which means you actually do it in your own consciousness, in your own imagination, in your own thoughts, in your own body, before you begin to act it out. An actor studies its script very, very intensely in that character before it gets on that stage. So what happens is we feel so inadequate, we feel so undeserving, we feel so unworthy that we work really hard in physical reality to try to balance that feeling out. You know, we rescue everyone around us. We take care of everyone. We say no thank you to help and support, even though we desperately need it. We're afraid to take challenges. We're afraid to stand on the stage because we've hurt others and others have hurt us. We haven't been able to trust people. We haven't been able to trust ourselves. Our intuition feels so normal to us that we don't really see the value of it. And when people tell us, wow, you're amazing, wow, you helped me so much, you're like, all I did was just talk to you. So you're devaluing your own gifts if that's all you feel like you have or don't have. So when we take unworthiness and we take deserving, those are two big reasons why your money blocks. That's why your abundance blocks. That's why wealth is not rolling in all forms. That's why opportunities are not showing up. Investors are not showing up. You know, because you've got the ideas, you've got the inventions, you've got the talent, you've got everything, but you've also got the inability to deserve because of some shame and guilt from the past. Okay, so just bear with me. I'm giving you the what's in the way first. Now, the other two frequencies that I know to be true that either create a major flow of abundance or they completely stop abundance is where you are not feeling free in your life. So we've got worthiness, deserving, freedom. Where do you feel trapped in your life? See, the universe doesn't see that things are in categories in your reality. It does not see that your inability to be free in your relationship also means that you're not free with money. Because freedom is a frequency and you're projecting it out, whether you feel free or whether you don't feel free, all the time. Now, most of us, even lightworkers, are still focused on what we do not have versus what we want, because we think that if we keep focusing on what we do not have, we're going to somehow get a solution for that. But vibrationally, we understand in quantum universe, if I'm looking at something, I'm making it bigger, not smaller. So if I'm looking at my lack, it's going to grow. No matter how much I'm trying to use my logical brain and my human ego to find some sort of solution, the solution doesn't exist in the human realms. It exists in the non-spiritual space of your imagination. It is where all of your brilliance and all of your genius is. It is where you're most comfortable living, or at least you were before you were told not to be there. And when we lose our freedom, I'm not talking about freedom of money only. I'm talking about freedom in a relationship to speak your truth, freedom at a job, freedom to create, freedom to, you know, spend time with yourself and the people that you want to spend time with. You know, how many of you guys have a relationship that you just can't create freedom in? or a job that you can't create freedom in, because this will affect your money flow because it's all connected. You are one unit of energy. So your money, your relationships, your health, your time are all in relationship to who and what you are. And law of attraction is speaking to all of this. And so when I don't feel free in my relationship, like I can't speak my truth, or I don't feel free to create a relationship because I'm devaluing myself somewhere, then I'm also going to stop my money line. And that money line is going to stop because I don't feel free. So I'm telling the universe, I need money to feel free. I need money to feel free. And the universe is going, right, you're not free. Here's some more representation of that. Here's some more reality to show you that you're not free. Am I doing good? Am I doing good? Do you see that you're not free? I'm matching exactly the feeling that you have inside of you. And no amount of physical effort, no amount of waking up and dedicating 6 hours to your craft and working out really hard and eating perfect foods and doing all the right things will ever increase your money flow the way that sitting back, looking at unworthiness, deserving, freedom, shame, guilt, humiliation, and your own personal value systems and what you really have to offer inside of this toolbox, until you start looking and taking stock of all of those things, no amount of physical activity will actually get you to the mountaintop. Now, changing your diet will get you more awareness. It will get you added bonus in health. It will bring you confidence. It will bring you to a new place of awareness. And from that new place of awareness, you can look deeper within. Bring the light to the dark. You got to bring that light within you into the dark systems of yourself, the old programs, the belief systems, mom's belief systems, your church's belief systems, all these things that don't resonate with who you currently are in this now moment. We have got to take responsibility, the ability to respond to what we believe, not on the surface, because on the surface is where your hopes and dreams, your action, your momentum, your motivation resides. And underneath that is the belief systems of this isn't going to work just like everything else. This person's going to hurt me just like everyone else has. This is not going to last. This opportunity is going to get ruined. And as long as we have that in the back of the mind, law of attraction says, I hear you. I hear you. 10 steps forward, 10 steps back. It's like the dance. It's the lightworker dance. And it's all time to stop. Because our job here is to bring light to the dark. So if you need to have a buckets of money to go do that, because that's your highest joy, then that's what we need and want. And there shouldn't be anything wrong with you having access to all forms of abundance on this planet. And money is just one right now that everybody focuses on from a needs perspective. And so why not master that one too until it's gone? It's our job to be able to play with all forms of abundance. And I know that if money is considered a dark system, the best thing that I could do with money is to bring light to it. I could bring light to this. I could show you guys how to hack the system, do some biohacking, get in alignment with your own worth, get in alignment with your ability to receive, no matter how uncomfortable it is, create freedom in your life, no matter what that means. And last but not least, the number one frequency that I always, every single person that's got money blocks comes to me every single time is safety issues. I'm not safe. I'm not safe. And a lot of times, catch 22, you're not safe because you don't have the money. You got all these big ideas that are as big as the universe. Your soul is as big as 10 suns and you got two pennies. That's a major safety issue because you're not able to really create on this planet the way that you want to, the way that you could. And so that triggers survival issues. Okay. So of course I got some fun definitions for you guys. I hope you're not bored yet because I know I am not. Let's look at the word safety, shall we? The condition of being protected from an unlikely cause danger. Thank you, mind, for always taking us there, no matter what. Okay? It's welfare, it's well-being, it's protection, it's security, right? So if we look at safety, how many safety programs do you have running right now in your life? Do you feel safe in your relationship? Do you feel safe in your body? Do you feel safe at work? Do you feel safe around your family? Do you feel safe around your own mind? Do you feel safe with your past? Do you still feel safe with your future thoughts? See, these are all things that if you get really honest with me today and you start thinking, I really don't feel safe there. I really don't feel safe there. Then I'm introducing you to your money blocks. It is something that I see every single time in every single person. And sometimes it's not about money. I've had very wealthy clients come to me and they can't create their hopes and dreams with tons of money in the bank. They've got tons of money in the bank. They drive great cars. They have wonderful houses, but they are not able to abundantly create their hopes and their dreams because they have safety programs somewhere. Safety in the relationship, right? Safety in their own mind, safety in all these other places. So you have to kind of go, where's my safety issues? And so where's my worth issues? Where's my deserving issues? Where's my safety issues? Where's my freedom issues? Because underneath all that BS that was programmed into you as a kid is so not your story. So not your story. It is a story that you adopted, that you borrowed, and now forgot that you don't have to use that story. And instead of giving it back and transcending it into light, we hide it, we bury it, and then we run from it in physical reality. And all we're doing is this big circle where we keep meeting it in our next venture, in our next relationship, in our next opportunity. And being a light worker does not protect you from any of this, because the spiritual community has just as much of these issues going on. They just use different language about it. You know, the spiritual community is still 90% in lack. You know, it is still dealing with major freedom issues, still dealing with deserving, still dealing with unworthiness, maybe not in the projected spaces that you travel and, you know, meditate together, but internally. So that's the baseline of what's in the way for you. Now, I have tons of workshops and I have about 6,000 hours of archived material where I teach the how to get rid of all those things. But I just want you to be aware of what's in the way. That's not what this webinar is actually about, but I felt like it was a very important foundation, because now that we know what you're not, let's dive into what you are. Let's dive into that toolbox that you have inside of you. Let's dive into the assets and the personal value that you have inside of you. See, as a light worker, you may have an abundance of knowledge, of knowing, of empathy, compassion, the ability to read energy, the ability to heal with your hands, the ability to move things around in time and space. And you may not see that as super valuable, but I will guarantee that someone who does not have access to that part of their toolbox would pay you greatly with what they do have. See, it's all about sharing abundance. It's about, I'm abundant in this and you're abundant in that. Let's trade. I don't have a lot of what you've got right now and you don't have a lot of what I've got. So let's trade. And, you know, I could use some of that green stuff to pay my mortgage. And you could use some of this information about, you know, while your life's not moving forward, or tell you about your twin flame, or let me do a healing on you. And to that person, you are priceless. But because you devalue yourself, and because we have been taught to be unworthy, then what we think we're giving them is not as valuable as the money that they're giving us. Or we're rejecting money because we don't want the money. And if we don't want the money, then you're going to have to get creative in your form of exchange, because I know a lot of wealthy people on this planet that are not living and using money. But at the same time, they are sharing abundance somehow, right? And that's what I'm going to share with you is my story, because this whole webinar is actually birthed from my story. And, you know, when I kind of walked away from the traditional 3D life, the solid job, the 40-hour a week paycheck, the 401k, the health insurance, the big mortgage, the leased lifestyle, the credit card debt. You know, when I walked away from that life, I was pretty much homeless. And I had three little daughters. And so you could see that now that I wasn't covering up those four frequencies, unworthiness, deserving, freedom, and safety, once I kind of went into the world with nothing to medicate myself with, I had to face all of those issues. And one of the things that I realized is that I was a light worker, even though I didn't know what to do with my light yet. I knew that all I wanted to do was help other people. That's it. If that's what you want, that's what you are. And I didn't know how I was going to do that. And so, like most of us light workers, what we do is we dive into study. We get the Reiki practitionership. We get the life coaching practitionership. We get this healing practitionership. We certification. We read this book. We take this class. We join this group. And what we're doing is we're not actually at all gaining anything that's not already inside of you. All these things are ever doing is reminding you of who you are. It is turning the switch. It's activating that back on within you. You can't be a Reiki practitioner if you are not a healer. And you are. And that's how you're looking at those signs and those symbols, and you're remembering who you are. And so if we would just begin to work on the unworthiness and the deserving, we would begin to remember everything without taking a billion classes or listening to thousands of hours of YouTube gurus. We would remember, because there isn't anything lightworkers came here to study or learn. We came here to teach and heal. We came to teach and heal this planet. We did not come to spend our entire life in school. Now, if we're in school, chronic school. You guys know what I'm talking about. It's part of the unworthiness program. If I get this class, I'll be more valuable. If I get this understanding, it will tie this together. And then I'll feel safe opening my practice and my wellness center and my website and my business. So just, if that's you, just, okay, I hear you. Put it over there for now. But understand that this webinar, I'm going to teach you about the two toolboxes that you have. First and foremost, you have an internal toolbox of diamonds and gold and jewels and magic and wealth and abundance and freedom already built inside of you. Things that you've been using and giving away and prostituting yourself your entire life with. And people knew that these were diamonds and gold, but because you didn't recognize the value of yourself, they just kept slowly taking. She's not charging me for this. She's not asking me for anything. She's not asking me to give her any information back. I'm just going to keep taking. Sound familiar? And then what we do is we realize, well, hey, this is valuable what I have. It may not feel valuable, but it is valuable. And people will exchange with me my abundance for your abundance. Isn't that what nature is doing with itself all the time? The rain grows the trees and the flowers. One form of abundance feeds the other. And so if we take the idea of money out of the equation for this webinar and we just look at exchanging abundance, and it's not about who's better or worse, it's about what is it in my heart that I have overflowing, that I love to give anyway, that I could start learning how to exchange with someone else. Maybe in the beginning, if you've got major money blocks and you're not willing to go on a deep journey into the shadows with me, maybe you start looking at your wealth as an exchange of abundance that is not always just money. And I had to start there, you guys, because I had some major poverty blocks. I had tons of lack. I felt completely unworthy. So I would be the type of person who would get an opportunity for money, and then it would like not work out in the end, or the person would just disappear or ghost me, or, you know, and it was like I could work really hard to get the opportunities, but they just never quite panned out. So I realized that my beliefs about money were deeper than I thought. So I needed to take more baby steps about how I created that wealth and abundance. And I knew that I had to do that because I had three little girls depending on me at the time. And hey, everybody needed to eat. At the end of the day, we all need to still eat and be here and feel safe under some sort of a roof, right? Even if it's nature's roof, we still want that feeling of safety, security, and abundance so that we can stop being in a state of survival and create the world that we came here to create. That's why we're here, is to create a new world. But if we're always in a survival program, just keeping your head above water, trying to figure out how to make it work, are you really, really able to utilize that toolbox inside of you? Some of you guys don't even know what's in there because you've been so busy surviving. And so if you took the survival game away and you realized that you were actually here to be creative and a genius and pull out all of these things inside of you, the things you've taken for granted about yourself, the things that other people constantly want from you, is so valuable, so valuable. And with knowing that, start to see yourself as valuable, because lightworkers are technically, if you guys really looked in the cosmos about the order of existence, lightworkers are literally the royal energy of the universe. And here we're like treated like ghetto slums, right? It's like we've got it all backwards, but it's all program and indoctrination. Not that we need to walk around arrogant or anything. It's just not even, that's not who we are. But to be able to give and receive from a worthy, deserving, safe, free space, do you see that flow? So when I was figuring this out, I had a past. My track record, let's just be honest, my track record was a nightmare. And it was filled with failures, broken agreements, broken trust on both sides. And I was very hesitant, or would feel like I would freeze when I was right about to kind of step out into the light and really, you know, do something proactive for myself. I would kind of go into that freeze because that belief system was like, remember the last time you failed, and remember how much money you spent on that last program, and remember how much, you know, and so I would just be like, oh gosh, I don't want to shame my family again or let my kids down. So I'll just do nothing. And then I'll go back and work this crappy job over here that makes me feel unfree, which further breaks my money flow. And so what I realized is, because I had this track record, that I needed to not put all of my eggs in one basket. And I hope you're tracking with me, because most of us, what we do is we count on one job or two small jobs to feed our entire reality. And if that one job goes down, oh goodness, right? And that's a fear that we keep in the back of our mind. And that's what keeps showing us up on the hamster wheel every day as well. I mean, I can't let this job go. And it's a product of you putting all of your eggs in one basket, just like your mom and dad taught you to. But because you're a light worker, you're naturally multidimensional, which means that you're not just one thing. Have you noticed how you're not just a life coach, but you're also a student, a teacher, a healer, a creator, a writer, a poet, a doctor, a shaman? Have you noticed that about yourself? And if you're just kind of waking up, you still know what I mean, because your hand in the cosmos is in every single cookie jar, because you are all that is. So you are not one limited being. Therefore, you should not be doing one limited thing, because if that left you, then you would be in a state of major security and major lack of freedom, and major survival issues would kick in. But that's what we do, because that's the way we're taught on this planet, is to put all of your faith and all of your focus and all of your energy into one job. Now, that job, think about it. We teach kids to go to school in a very expensive college, and then we get them thrown into debt. And then we go, I really hope you love what you went to school for. I will tell you, only about 40%, maybe less now that the indigos are here, probably more like 20% of people who have a physical degree are using it in their life to create their lives and their realities and their paychecks. Only 20%, which means that you thought you wanted something, you went to school for it, you went into debt for it maybe, and then you started working and you were like, nah. I mean, I know a lot of hairdressers that are not hairdressers anymore. They're doing tarot cards in the back of their hair salon, and they didn't go to school for it. They just saw someone doing it on YouTube, and they were like, wow, I really love that. And they bought a deck, and they're like, oh my gosh, I'm so awesome at this. Guess what? You now have a PhD in tarot card readings because you love it, you're awesome, and you're good at it. And because you're good at it, you can exchange that currency with someone who's good at making money. Let them give you that. So the longer we stay in these jobs that are not completely feeding our joy and completely making our heart explode, the more we are suffering. And the more we suffer, the more we fall into the fear category with those that are asleep. We don't want to be part of the problem, guys. We want to be part of the solution. So the solution is to face your life and go, am I really happy here? Could I do 25 different little things that would equal to this paycheck? And could I thrive? And you guys, that is exactly what I've done, because I didn't really think that I was that good at anything when I first started. So I thought about working for a company where I could really, and I'll just tell you the backstory. So when I realized that I could no longer work a 9-to-5 job or I would die, right? And that freedom was important to me and creativity was important to me and servicing others the way that I wanted to service others was important to me, I realized that I could never work for anyone else again. And I'm sure you feel like that at some level. And I didn't know what I could do. I didn't know what I was good at. I just knew that I knew how to read people pretty well. I knew that I was very empathic. I knew that I was very compassionate. I knew I loved being a mom. I knew a lot about nutrition. I knew a lot about biochemistry. But it's like I didn't want to go work at some pharmaceutical lab. And I didn't see how I was going to make a living from that. So I found a company that had a vitamin supplement. And I decided that I was going to hide myself in their vitamins. And I was going to become the spokesperson for their vitamins. And I was going to teach classes about their vitamins, and I was going to show up. And I started to make a lot of money for myself and this company, much more for this company than myself. But I started doing well. And all along, I hadn't really fixed my worthiness issues. So I really felt like it was this vitamin that was making me wealthy. When I realized that this nobody knew about this vitamin until I started talking about it. And so what was actually making me money was me. And very soon after that, something happened with this vitamin company, and they went into a couple of different bankruptcies. And like that, you guys, I lost all of my money. All of it. And what I realized is that I was hiding my toolbox in a company, but because I didn't have something outside of me to give someone anymore, I was like, what am I going to do? And so I hit this place of going, okay, well, what was I actually doing with people? Oh my gosh, I was inspiring them. I was educating them. I was helping them. Well, if there's this vitamin, there's got to be lots of other vitamins. But you guys, I learned my lesson in that moment. I was never, ever, ever going to put my heart and my soul into one in someone else's company that could change overnight, that I couldn't be responsible for the frequencies and vibrations of them. So what I decided to do was I still wanted to work with products and people, and I wanted to share my inside toolbox with my outside toolbox because I knew a lot about nutrition. So let's look at all of the things that you guys are already using in your lives. You know, if you're a light worker, you probably got an essential oil on right now. Okay. If you are a light worker, you're probably recommending to your unconscious family some CBD, right? If you're a light worker, you're meditating. So it's like, think about the things that you're already doing. Now let's take some scales back, because I just gave you three ideas, but you might be like, well, I'm already doing that. But let me show you that if you start to work more with this inside toolbox and you start sharing your light in the dark, which is dark is lack of information, guys. There's certain people that don't know that you can heal anything with what you've already healed that with. Your information is vital on this planet. And doctors, if you're listening to me, close your ears for a minute, unless you are quantum healers. Lightworkers will be replacing physical, medical trained doctors on this planet in the next 5 years. And the reason why is the third dimensional medicine that is there to help with post manifestational awareness of out of alignment behavior will no longer be necessary. Because what we know is that the body is designed to heal itself, and the body has its own pharmacy. So if we can get the body in the right frequencies and vibrations, the body can heal from anything, anything. Okay. And we also know that there's other outside frequencies that we can use, plants, herbs, technology, light, sound, that we can use to remind the body of that particular frequency, and the body can match itself and heal. Sound healers, you guys know what I'm talking about. Shamans, you know what I'm talking about here, is that the medicine of the future is finding the resonant frequency point and matching it to the body, and the body has a spontaneous healing. But we also have to make sure that this mind is not dictating the body, that the mind is listening to the will of the soul and the gut and the heart and the higher self to help navigate and receive the frequencies that are being given. So the basics of this webinar is that first and foremost, you have this amazing toolbox inside of you that you are devaluing, okay? That you are not claiming your worth, that you are not saying that the fact that I go hug strangers or feed homeless isn't enough. That is such bullshit, you guys. It is enough. It is enough because children below the age of 5, just by being adorable, just by waking up in the morning, guarantees their worth, guarantees their place, hopefully, if they were in a good family. Now, some of us weren't. So we learned unworthiness very, very early on. But it is also your responsibility now to rewire that belief system within you, because you're serving the world at 10% of your capability when you're harboring these belief systems about yourself. So when we go back to the idea of creating wealth and abundance, it is really about doing what you're already doing. It's about creating a flow of abundance with what you already are working with, which means I want to create abundance of flow with my value inside of me, which means whatever I have inside of me that someone else doesn't have, I'm going to play a game where I'm going to share and receive this shift in abundance, which means I have something to give. What do you have to give? Which means you guys are going to have to go work on your issues around receiving, okay, and your worthiness issue, but that's another class. So I'm going to practice this. And then I'm like, wow, I'm abundant in this. You're abundant in that. I don't devalue myself by needing what you have. You're not devaluing yourself by needing what I have. Notice how people are so grateful for you. Notice how they're so excited to hear your messages. And all they're giving you is piddly little money that you're going to go buy some toilet paper and laundry detergent with. You're like, whatever. You see the value in you, and they're going to go home and they're going to be like, oh my gosh, I met this woman today and she told me this and she told me that. And then she told this. And you know what she's going to do? She's going to talk you up so much. 5 people are going to be like, I need to go see this person. 5 people are going to be like, what's her name? And then 5 people, because you created such a valuable impact in their life in a 1-hour session or a bump of the, you know, shoulder crossing paths, getting onto a bus, because you know you've done those sessions, sitting next to someone in the park, they're now going and telling 5 people about you. You've not only changed the reality, you've created a ripple effect by your very presence of your heart. And what did their money do? It bought you detergent, right? Well, if you're like me, it buys you oils and CBD, it buys you all kinds of really good stuff. But do you see the value in that? Do you see how it's super important for you to be able to share, but also to receive? And also, there's a law of exchange on this planet. If you do not get something in exchange for the value inside of you, you will naturally begin to feel devalued. Okay? Law of the universe, guys. I'm not making this up. This is not so I want you to go out and have millions and millions of dollars, because if you're like me and you get to that point, you're just going to give it away anyways. So it's just about having the option to be able to create majorly in a huge way on this planet. You know, that's feeding the planet. That's creating water flow for this planet. That is changing systems on this planet. That is bringing in new energy on this planet. That does not happen without money, because we have to have something to go up against the idea of what is going on with the planet. That's all another class, and that's another webinar. But back to the toolbox. So what I've done over my life as a single mom with no child support, no family support, no friends in the beginning, was I just decided that I would share the abundance of value that I did have. Some of that was in the form of knowledge. Some of that was in the form of my personal time. Some of that was in the form of research for others. Some of that was in the form of healings. Some of that was in the form of very important products that I had my heart behind. And then what I realized was that by the time I stopped having safety issues around money, I had 5 or 6 sources of income. And it was amazing, because when one line would dry up, another line would be abundant. Or I didn't worry so much about this one line drying up because there was still trickles coming in. And I'm not going to say that I made $1 million with these five sources of income in the beginning. But what it was it was constant state of security, because getting a $10 check in the mail for a light worker is like, it is like getting a nickel from your uncle when you're five. It's like, oh my gosh, I got just free money comes to me. Free money comes to me. So what we're doing by being of value and being of service and using both of our toolbox, the toolbox that you have inside and your external toolbox of products that are very, very valuable to you, whether it's your own book you've written, your own workshop you've created, your own private practice, you know, the oils you're selling, the CBD you're selling, whatever it is you're selling on the outside of you, is about having an abundance of ways to exchange energy. And that what it does is it puts you into the mindset of it puts you into the mindset of abundance naturally, because now you're not lacking. You know that feeling when you think about getting fired and not having a way to pay your bills, even though you desperately want to quit? Do you guys know that feeling? It's like the worst feeling in the world, because you're like in jail, but you're like, please don't let me out of jail because then I'm going to die. It's like this really scary feeling. So in the beginning, what we want to do is we want to baby step this. And we really want to take this idea of having this personal abundance inside of us. And have you guys noticed how I'm not saying, okay, now go spend $2,000 on my mastermind money class. I'm never going to do that to you, because money is too important on this planet for lightworkers for me to charge for this. It is too important. So it is about you guys going, what do I have right now? Where I am with what I have right now without spending a dime or a dollar, getting really centered with what I am. Using what I'm already disseminating, using and talking about the products that I'm already using, and get an exchange of energy from them. So by the time I opened my wellness centers in 2014, I had five sources of income, which meant that if the coaching clients didn't show up, you know, my brain tap technology was still going to pay my bills. The other forms of abundance that I had in my other five income sources were kind of trickling in, and they were keeping me out of fear, because we only dive into fear when we get into that void zero point. When it's empty is when we get really scared. I've also noticed a trend in lightworkers the last few years is you guys are like, I'm done with the system. I'm going to deplete my 401k. I'm going to go start my business, and I'm going to live as a lightworker. I cannot tell you how many mentor students have come to me in the last 2 years that are living like kings because they've liquidated their 401k, and they're going on the trips that they're healing their inner child with new things, but they're not taking into account that devalued program and that unworthiness program is going to surface as soon as that 401k runs out. So if that's you, what I want you to do is I want you to really pay attention to my next free webinar that I'm going to do next month. Because in my next free webinar that I'm going to do next month right here is I'm going to share with you guys the 25 forms of revenue that I have coming in right now. I could have more, but when I actually wrote down, I think I got too bored after 25, but I've got 25 sources of income that are coming into me right now. And only 1, 2, 3, 4 of them do I physically have to exert any energy for? Do I have to show up for? Do I have to place my time in? And only 2 of them I invest money in. So you can see that I am not telling you here to liquidate your 401k and go buy into this company over here. I'm saying, who are you inside that you're abundant as? What is the value that you have in your heart? What are you already using outside of you that you love, support, endorse? I mean, how many products have you guys literally endorsed that you've never saw any exchange for? And you know what? You probably, if you're like me in the past, been like, oh no, it's cool. I just want someone to have that. But that's fine. But it's not okay for you to drown. There's an inner child inside of you that wants that playground and wants that lifestyle and wants a house and wants security and good food to eat. It's not about repenting as a spiritual being on this planet and using our light only for service of others. It is first to fill up our own cup and to heal our own past and to love ourselves and to value ourselves and to see the worth in us. Because then when we do step out of the world in a light working business, we're going to have boundaries. We're not going to be taken advantage of. We're not going to get into business with people who just want to take from us. We're not going to get into these twin flame relationships and get ghosted and get your heart twisted around. We're going to stop doing that, because when we start valuing ourselves, we start to create really awesome boundaries. And these boundaries provide you with an opportunity to decide and have a choice about how you want your life to unfold. Because bottom line, guys, I don't care how many gurus say it, it's the absolute truth. You are creating your reality, and you're creating your reality from those belief systems, which you may not even be aware that you have. If you have any block in your life, even outside of money, it is because there is something inside of you that is speaking to law of attraction, saying that I can't have, I'm not free, I'm not safe, I'm not worth it. So we need to clean that out. And the way that we can clean that out is we can take our power back right here, right now, with nothing. Right here with nothing, you could say, what do I have? What is my potential? Where are my limitations? Because you know what, you guys, where are limitations is where someone else is abundant. I have staff in my company that love doing the things that I hate. Love. It is their highest joy. And you know what we're doing in our company is we're sharing abundance. Their abundance and knowledge of this, that, and that. And I'm abundant in what I'm abundant with. And in we're sharing abundance, we're creating this support system and this connection-based team to service and provide light on the planet, which is all of our mission here. And we also want to learn how to work well with the others, right? We want to stop having to block people on social media because we posted something that we believe in. Aren't we done with this phase? You know, this all comes down to humiliation and worth and deserving and security issues and safety issues. And all of that means nothing because of what's inside of you. So take what you have inside of you. Take what you're already endorsing and turn it into an exchange of energy. Exchange of energy. Maybe you don't have the $50 to go get signed up as an oil distributor, but you know everything there is about oil. You know, oils, you could literally exchange energy in, this is what I know, I can help you with this. And in return, I could use my website being built, or you could write a blog about me, or you could feature me on your website. It's all about getting really creative in the areas where the money isn't flowing yet, because where the money is not flowing yet does not mean abundance is not flowing. Abundance is the ability to do what you want to do when you want to do it and how you want to do it, people. It has nothing to do with money. Money is just one of those fun things when it starts to come into you. To me, what I've noticed money does is the fast forward process. Because I've bartered websites, I've bartered companies, I've bartered rent, I've bartered houses, I've bartered cars, I've bartered everything, you guys. And it's cool that you can do that, but it takes longer. Because this hoop got to jump through this. When you got money, you're just like, I'm just going to pay. And it's like, oh, that's so easy, right? This is nice to be able to have that. But that's not the only form of abundance we want to create here. We want to create an abundance of where our limits are and give away the abundance of where our potential and our power and our greatness already exists. So the formula for becoming a wealthy light worker on this planet is first and foremost realizing what you have underneath that you're already giving away. And then understanding what you use that you're already using, that you're giving away. We can flip the switch on this. We can turn this into abundance. We can then in the after hours of when we're not producing a flow, we work on our safety issues and our freedom issues and our worthiness issues and our deservings. We practice the art of receiving. We practice the art of giving and receiving at the same time. And we also we look around our lives and we see, where do we need to create more freedom? Where are we being our own warden? Where are we stealing our own joy? Where are we creating our own suffering? And obviously, you know, I am a mentor. And so I see that that's not super easy to do by yourself, because you need a mirror. You need that mirrored consciousness sometimes to see your blind spots. But that's why we're here, people. That's why you've got these amazing mentors on this planet that are here to show you those blind spots so they can tweak that frequency and that frequency. But for right now, if you've just listened to this webinar and you've never watched me again, or you've never seen me before, and you took to heart some of these elements of what I'm saying to you, is that you're going to create freedom for yourself by having multiple streams of focus. You're not going to get locked in to one idea of I've got to make it as a life coach. I've got to make it as a healer. I've got to do this right or I'm going to starve. We've got to eliminate the safety issue by having 5 to 25 sources of income so that you can start feeling safe. We have to have play-based businesses so that you do not lose your soul in exchanging your time for money. You have to create a reality where work feels like play, which means you need to heal your relationships with time. But you see how exchanging what your abundance is, you guys know when you're giving that amazing advice, time passes, you're not hungry, you don't need anything, you're in this accelerated space of expansion, and all you want to do is keep showing up. Do you know that that's who you really are? And you could actually get paid to be yourself on this planet? Do you know that the toolbox inside of you was designed to feed you, clothe you, and take care of you? It's not about hiding and suppressing this and go working a job so that you have to further, you know, trap yourself. And that the only thing that's ever going to do is create a sick body, create unhealthy relationships, and create mental warfare within you. So by creating multiple streams of income, you guys, you're going to clear your safety issues. Okay. You're also going to get really creative and you're going to have to stop overthinking because you're going to start creating in these ways of sharing your heart versus sharing your logic. Okay. When you share your heart, you amplify and you multiply abundance. When you share your mind, you're sharing the past and potential futures, which means that you're dealing in some sort of limitations. Okay, so healing your freedom issues is about changing the way that you do your business so that it feels more like play. It should be 80% of energy work, 20% showing up. Okay, I have these formulas in my academy, you guys, is simple financial abundance space formulas, 80% visualizing, imagining, doing the groundwork, setting up the space, clearing out the lack, surrendering, inspired action, rendezvous point with the investor, right? Getting the money out of the 401k and taking my advice and doing this, or being completely out of your 401k and going, well, what's left? With my 401k, I bought 14 different certifications. I did Burning Man. I did this. I am an expert. What is expert? What is an expert? It's first experience, right? Experience that turns into, you turn into an expert the second that you have experience. And it's about acceleration. So the more you use it, the more you feel good about it, the more you feel valuable about it. Notice the next time you just give away a free life coaching session or a healing or a reading for someone, notice what you're actually giving them, how you're changing their entire world in that 20 minutes or that hour, and start reflecting in and be proud of yourself and say, I did that. It's okay for me. It's not arrogant for me to be self-gratification. It's not arrogant for me to be grateful for what I just did for someone. If I would actually start focusing more on that, then I would get more, because what you appreciate appreciates. So if you appreciate more of what you're doing so naturally, you'll realize how valuable it is on this planet. You'll realize that this is why you're here. And if you can take my advice and take some inside toolbox and start exchanging it for abundance, and you can take some outside toolboxes that you have that you're already working with, you know, I'm going to show you guys the exact 25 that I'm using. It's not going to be necessarily the 25 that you guys want to use, but I'm going to tell you that I did all of this with completely no money, no help, no support, no education behind 99% of this. All I had was this deep desire to help, and I could only use what I have from where I was. So listen to this idea about becoming the wealth that you already are, utilizing the things you're already using outside of you to triple your investments, so that you can start having a $10 check from over here coming and a $15 check. Guys, at the end of the day, it's like you could have a couple of, at the end of the month, you could have a couple of $100 that you weren't expecting by just sharing what you already know about something. But don't put your eggs in one basket, okay? We've been burned too many times to feel safe with putting all in one idea. That's why you're also multidimensional. That's why you're also multi-gifted, is so that you can help over here. And we're also dealing with an ascension process. So sometimes we're helping people more with money. And then sometimes we're going to be helping more people with our bodies. And that's why you know how to do all of it. And maybe you're saying, well, I don't know how to do that yet. I just want you to plant the seed in your consciousness that you actually do, and that you're just here to remember. You're just remember the who, not the how. Your job is just to remember the who, not the how. The how is the universe's job. As soon as you start to remember who you are, the universe says, there you are. I've been waiting for you. You're not here to struggle. You're here to play. And you're here to teach people that through play and breaking down old systems and providing knowledge and providing security and safety of someone's own heart and being compassionate is your paycheck. So hopefully you guys had something in this webinar that speak to you, that helped you. And next month, because there's just so much information, that next month I'm going to give you guys a really, really intimate look into my own finances and the 25 streams of income that I have going on right now that are helping me create my mission. They're helping me build my tours so that I can go all around this planet and activate, you know, light inside of people using light language and quantum technologies and sound and medicine of the future. And we can go all over the world and do this because of this abundance that we've created. And we can be of service to so many people at different levels of consciousness, because not everybody is ready to study quantum theory. Some people just need to learn how to meditate. And so I have a system for that, so that I can utilize that. And I'm also creating abundance for myself while I'm teaching someone how to do that over here in this stream of income. But every single thing that I'm creating, endorsing, and producing is in perfect alignment of my soul signature to be a service on this planet and to be the light in the dark. So thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you join me next month. I hope that if you just stumbled across my webinar from Instagram or YouTube or someone else's page, that you check in with us next month. I don't have the time yet, but I will list out the streams of income and I will invite you guys, if you're interested, to jump into a free mastermind program after that to help you guys develop your own systems of revenue and wealth and abundance and freedom and safety, because that's really what it's about, is creating that safety within your heart so that you can be here to live your mission out loud and to live your purpose really authentically without having to hide or dim your light anymore, guys. So thank you for joining me. I want to remind you that tickets are on sale right now for our Quantum Revolution Tour. We're right here in Kansas City, the heart chakra of the United States. That is September 28th weekend. You can find those tickets for sale at the quantumrevolutiontour.com. Also, if you are interested in going deep in those worthiness issues, I've got two powerful workshops right now listed on that website. And one is Warrior Training, and that is there to find all of your old really rooted negative belief systems that are holding you back. You can go through that workshop, or you can get your ticket for the I Am workshop that I will be starting at the end of July, which is basically the integration of the higher self in the human body. We're ready to be superheroes, and we're ready to integrate ego back into its truest form, which is focus and opportunities to help the higher self embody all the magic on this planet, to bring the alchemy to life. That's the true purpose of the ego. So that's what that workshop is. And it's also designed, there's a lot of heavy, heavy shadow work in that workshop. So if you're ready to go deep, you can go ahead and register for the I Am workshop. And it's all at thequantumrevolutiontour.com. Thank you guys so much for joining me for this. If you do have questions that you want me to answer next time, please list them in the comments. We'll get them written down and I'll make sure that I answer all of your questions in the next webinar. For now, have a great rest of your Sunday or Monday, wherever you are on the planet. And I will see you guys real soon. Thank you for letting me be of service, and have a great time sharing abundance this week.